Hi, this is Graham. Hope everyone's having a great day. This is a supplementary video to the second video I posted on understanding the FZ150 camera. This will be a practical extension to the programmed auto mode, or the P mode, with some demonstration of how to use the programmed auto mode to try and get some better pictures from the FZ150 camera. I'm first of all setting up the camera in intelligent auto mode and full wide angle, and I'm going to take the first picture using self timer mode. And the second shot I'll take with the programmed auto mode, just to show the difference in the zoom effect of the 1.3 digital zoom. What I want to demonstrate now is the effect of the metering mode of the camera. Currently I'm set up for full area metering, so we'll take one more shot with full area metering and then compare that to center weighted and then spot. I'm now going to show you the effect of the photostyles. The scene you've got in front of you, the Astley Hall, is quite a high contrast subject. There's quite a lot of sunshine on the building, with the white window frames and the shadows in the background of the building. It's quite a high contrast range, so it's pushing the camera to its extreme limits to be able to capture all the detail in highlights and shadows. I'm going to use the standard profile first of all, without any adjustment, so it's a standard profile with standard saturation, sharpness and contrast, and we'll see how that looks. Vivid. And now, natural. Now we're going to the monochrome mode. Now the scenery mode. And now we'll go to the portrait mode. The final mode is the custom mode. I'm going to take the contrast to -2 and the saturation to -2. I want to now demonstrate the effect of exposure compensation. Thank you. as you can see from the preceding samples, a lot of this work is quite subjective and is down to personal preferences. Sometimes it's much easier to work with a lower saturation or natural profile and then post-process the image. Although this does include a lot more work, you can actually set this up as a script in Adobe Photoshop or a Corel X2, something like that, so that you just import the whole directory and apply the same process to all your images. This way you get a consistent result. So in the next video we're going to be looking at the aperture priority, shutter priority and manual modes, and how to use these and when to use them. So again, thanks for watching, hope to see you in the next video, and if you don't already subscribe, please consider doing so. So that's Graham saying thanks again, see you next time.